वेलकम टू साईटेक AI यूटोपिया। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट फायर एंड हाउ थिंग्स बर्न, इग्निशन, कम्बस्चन, रिएक्शंस, फ्यूल, फ्लेम, ऑल दैट सॉर्ट ऑफ स्टफ। नाउ थिंग्स कैन गेट ए बिट रिपीटेटिव, बट दैट इज टू जनरेट सम रिकॉल वैल्यू। आई विल ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन इन मैनी वेज। फर्स्टली ए ब्रीफ इन्फो ऑन फायर, देन आई विल एक्सप्लेन इन मोर डेप्थ। एट इट्स कोर, फायर इज ए सेल्फ सस्टेनिंग केमिकल रिएक्शन दैट अकर्स बिटवीन ए फ्यूल सोर्स, एन ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट, यूजली ऑक्सीजन इन द एयर, एंड एन एक्सटर्नल हीट सोर्स। दिस रिएक्शन, कॉमनली नोन एज कम्बस्चन, रिलीजेस एनर्जी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ हीट एंड लाइट। द प्रोसेस इज ऑफ्टन विजुअलाइज्ड एज फ्लेम्स, बट द फ्लेम्स देमसेल्व्स आर नॉट द फायर। They are the visible manifestation of the underlying chemical reactions. To kick start the combustion process, a certain temperature threshold known as the ignition temperature must be reached. This initiates the breakdown of the fuel into simpler molecules, producing volatile gases that can react with oxygen. Understanding fire requires a closer look at its three essential components: the fuel, oxygen and heat, often referred to as the fire triangle. Fuel is the material that undergoes combustion. It can take various forms, including solid, such as wood, the liquid, like gasoline, or gas, like natural gas. The type of fuel influences the characteristics of the fire. The oxygen is an oxidizing agent. Oxygen from the air is crucial for combustion. The availability of oxygen determines the efficiency and intensity of the fire. In some context, this relationship is illustrated with the fire tetrahedron, which includes a fourth component, a chemical reaction. Heat is the external energy source that raises the temperature of the fuel to its ignition point. Once ignited, the combustion process becomes self-sustaining as it generates its heat. Before the flames we commonly associate with fire, there is a preliminary stage called pyrolysis. This is where the heat induces the breakdown of complex organic compounds in the fuel into simpler molecules. In wood, for instance, cellulose, hemicellulose, and lignin undergo pyrolysis, releasing volatile gases, tars and charcoal. The chemical reaction begins with combustion. It involves the chemical reaction between the volatile gases produced during pyrolysis and oxygen. For example, consider the combustion of methane, CH4, which is a component of natural gas. Methane combines with oxygen to produce carbon dioxide and water vapor. This chemical reaction releases energy in the form of heat and light, giving rise to the flames we observe. The appearance of flames is not random. It is a result of complex interactions within the combustion process. Flames exhibit various colors, temperatures, and shapes, providing insights into the conditions of the fire. The color of flames depends on the temperature of the fire. Cooler flames tend to be red or orange, while hotter flames can appear yellow, blue, or even white. This color spectrum is a result of incandescence, where hot particles emit light. The shape of flames is influenced by factors such as airflow and the geometry of the burning material. A well-ventilated fire may produce elongated, pointed flames, while a confined space can lead to more turbulent, flickering flames. Flames at the base of a fire are generally cooler, while those at the top are hotter. This temperature variation is a consequence of the heat transfer within the combustion process. Oxygen plays a pivotal role in the combustion process. The efficiency and nature of a fire are significantly influenced by the availability of oxygen. In an ideal scenario with ample oxygen, combustion is complete, resulting in the production of carbon dioxide and water vapor. This is considered a cleaner form of combustion. While in situations where oxygen is limited, incomplete combustion occurs. This leads to the production of carbon monoxide and other byproducts, which can be harmful and contribute to air pollution. The balance between fuel and oxygen is critical for achieving optimal combustion efficiency and minimizing the production of undesirable byproducts. One of the remarkable aspects of fire is its ability to transform chemical energy stored in the fuel into thermal energy, which is felt as heat. The heat generated during combustion is a result of the breaking and forming of chemical bonds. Understanding the principles of heat transfer within a fire is essential. Conduction, convection, and radiation are the primary modes of heat transfer. Conduction involves the direct transfer of heat through a material. Convection is the movement of heat through fluids like air. And radiation is the transfer of heat through electromagnetic waves. In a fire, these modes of heat transfer contribute to the spread of flames, the warming of surrounding materials, and the overall dynamics of the fire. While fire is an essential tool for human civilization, it also has environmental implications. Uncontrolled fires, such as wildfires, can have far-reaching effects on ecosystems, air quality, and climate. In nature, fires play a role in ecological processes, but uncontrolled wildfires can result in widespread destruction. They can lead to the loss of habitat, soil erosion, and long-term ecological changes. The combustion of certain materials releases pollutants into the air, particulate matter, carbon monoxide, and other harmful substances can affect air quality, posing health risks for both humans and animals. The release of greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide contribute to climate change. While some fires are part of natural carbon cycles, human activities such as deforestation and the burning of fossil fuels intensify these impacts. Given its potential for destruction, understanding fire is crucial for safety and prevention. Identifying and eliminating potential fire hazards such as faulty wiring or flammable materials is a fundamental step in fire prevention. Firefighters use various techniques, including application of water, foam, or specialized extinguishing agents to control and extinguish fires. Understanding how fire spreads and behaves aids in the development of effective emergency response plans, ensuring the safety of individuals and minimizing property damage. So, this was a brief info on fire. I will summarize in another way. Fire is a chemical reaction that occurs when a combustible substance reacts with oxygen in the presence of heat, resulting in the release of energy in the form of light and heat. This phenomena is known as combustion, which is a complex process involving the rapid oxidation of a fuel. Wood, a common combustible material, is composed of organic compounds, primarily cellulose, hemicellulose, and lignin. When exposed to heat, such as an open flame, the process of pyrolysis initiates. Pyrolysis involves the decomposition of wood by heat in the absence of oxygen, leading to the release of volatile gases, tars, and charcoal. This phase serves as a precursor to combustion, preparing the fuel for the subsequent reaction with oxygen. As the temperature rises, the volatile gases produced during pyrolysis become susceptible to oxidation. Once these gases encounter oxygen in the air, they undergo combustion, releasing energy in the form of heat and light. The exothermic nature of combustion sustains the process, maintaining the high temperatures necessary for continuous pyrolysis and combustion reactions. The combustion of wood can be broken down into three main stages: ignition, flame propagation, and extinction. Ignition marks the initiation of combustion when the fuel reaches a temperature sufficient to start pyrolysis. In the case of wood, this typically occurs at around 300 degrees Celsius. As pyrolysis progresses, volatile gases like methane, ethylene, and carbon monoxide are released. Flame propagation follows ignition, characterized by the visible flames as the volatile gases react with oxygen. The heat generated in this phase sustains the high temperatures required for pyrolysis to continue. The flame front advances through the fuel, consuming it in the process. The luminosity of the flames results from the incandescence, the emission of light by hot particles and gases in the flame. The chemical reaction underlying wood combustion involves the combination of carbon from the fuel with oxygen from the air to produce carbon dioxide and water vapor. The equation represents the oxidation of cellulose, where oxygen acts as the oxidizing agent, breaking down the complex organic molecules into simpler compounds. The release of energy in the form of heat and light is a result of the rearrangement of chemical bonds during this exothermic reaction. The final stage is extinction, where the combustion process ceases either due to the depletion of fuel or a lack of oxygen. If the supply of wood is abundant and oxygen is readily available, combustion can persist for an extended period. However, when the fuel is exhausted or the oxygen supply is limited, the flames gradually diminish and the fire extinguishes. Now, let us talk about some terminologies and how things burn. Let us start with ignition. The ignition marks the initiation of the combustion process, where a substance transitions from a non-flammable state to a state capable of sustaining a fire. Various sources can trigger ignition, and the nature of these sources depends on the characteristics of the material involved. For example, consider a scenario involving the ignition of a piece of paper using a matchstick. In this case, the matchstick serves as the ignition source. Friction between the match head and the striking surface generates heat, initiating a chemical reaction within the match head. This reaction produces a small flame, which is the external ignition source. The flame from the matchstick comes into contact with the paper. Now let us talk about fuel. The fuel is a vital component in the combustion process, providing the substance that will undergo chemical reactions with oxygen to release energy in the form of heat and light. Different materials possess varying levels of combustibility, and the type of fuel influences the characteristics of the resulting fire. For example, continuing with the paper and matchstick scenario, the paper serves as the fuel in this case. Paper is composed of cellulose fibers, which are organic compounds containing carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. When the flame from the matchstick contacts the paper, it initiates the combustion of cellulose. The heat from the flame breaks down cellulose molecules into simpler compounds like water vapor and carbon dioxide. The carbon atoms released during combustion combine with oxygen from the air to form carbon dioxide. Now let us talk about oxygen. Oxygen is an essential element for combustion, serving as the oxidizing agent in the chemical reactions that take place during a fire. The availability of oxygen influences the combustion rate and the completeness of the reaction. For example, continuing the scenario of burning paper, as the match ignites the paper, oxygen from the surrounding air is drawn into the combustion zone. Oxygen molecules react with the carbon and hydrogen present in the cellulose of the paper. This chemical reaction is a key part of the combustion process, producing carbon dioxide and water vapor. The flame's visible brightness is a result of incandescence from hot gases produced by the reaction of oxygen with the paper's components. The continuous availability of oxygen ensures the sustained combustion of the paper. Now let us talk about chemical reaction. The combustion is fundamentally a chemical reaction known as oxidation, involving the rapid combination of fuel with oxygen to release energy. The chemical reactions occurring during combustion vary based on the composition of the fuel, influencing the products formed and the heat released. For example, expanding on the chemical reactions in the burning paper scenario, the cellulose, which is a primary component of paper, undergoes combustion according to the general formula. Here, in simpler terms, cellulose combines with oxygen to produce carbon dioxide and water. The breaking of chemical bonds in cellulose releases energy in the form of heat and light. The exothermic nature of this reaction sustains the fire, as the heat generated further supports the combustion of adjacent cellulose molecules. Chemical reaction is a crucial aspect of combustion, distinguishing it from simple burning, as it involves the rearrangement of atoms to form new compounds. Now let us talk about exothermic reaction. Combustion is classified as an exothermic reaction, meaning it releases energy in the form of heat and light. Exothermic nature of combustion is a fundamental characteristic that distinguishes it from endothermic reactions, where energy is absorbed. For example, expanding on the exothermic nature in the burning paper scenario, the chemical reaction between cellulose and oxygen is highly exothermic, releasing a significant amount of heat. The heat generated raises the temperature of the surrounding air, creating an upward convection current that sustains the flame. The energy released is also responsible for the glowing appearance of the flame, as particles in the flame become incandescent due to the intense heat. The exothermic reaction is self-sustaining as long as the necessary conditions like ignition, fuel, and oxygen persist, allowing for the continuous release of energy. Now let us talk about heat transfer. Heat transfer plays a crucial role in the combustion process. It involves the movement of thermal energy from the ignited material to adjacent fuel, causing a chain reaction. Understanding how heat is transferred helps explain the spread of fire and the involvement of surrounding materials in the combustion process. For example, elaborating on heat transfer in the burning paper scenario, as the cellulose molecules in the paper break down, heat is released as an inherent part of the exothermic reaction. This heat is transferred to nearby unburned cellulose molecules through conduction. The heated cellulose molecules undergo pyrolysis, a process where they decompose into flammable gases and char. These gases rise, and if they reach their ignition temperature, they can catch fire, contributing to the overall combustion process. Heat transfer mechanisms, including conduction, convection, and radiation, ensure that the fire spreads through the available fuel, sustaining the combustion chain. Now let us talk about flammable vapors. Certain materials release flammable vapors when heated, contributing to the overall combustibility of a substance. This phenomena is particularly relevant in scenarios where liquids or volatile compounds are involved, as these vapors can ignite and participate in the combustion process. For example, expanding on flammable vapors in the context of a gasoline spill. Imagine a scenario where a small amount of gasoline is spilled in a well-ventilated area. Gasoline is a liquid composed of hydrocarbons and it evaporates readily at room temperature. As the spilled gasoline interacts with the surrounding air, it releases vapors that mix with oxygen. If an ignition source such as a spark or an open flame is introduced, the mixture of gasoline vapors and oxygen can ignite, initiating combustion. The combustion of gasoline vapors is characterized by a rapid release of energy, producing a flame and generating heat that sustains the reaction. Now let us talk about pyrolysis. Before combustion, solid fuels undergo pyrolysis, a process where they decompose into volatile gases and char when exposed to heat. Pyrolysis is a crucial step in the combustion of solid materials and contributes to the generation of flammable gases that support the overall combustion process. For example, elaborating on pyrolysis in the context of burning wood, consider a piece of wood exposed to heat, such as from a match or a lighter. As the temperature rises, the wood undergoes pyrolysis, breaking down into volatile gases, tar and char. Volatile gases, including methane, ethane, and others, are released during pyrolysis and serve as fuel for combustion. If an ignition source is present, these gases can catch fire, producing a flame. The char left behind after pyrolysis is essentially carbon-rich material that can further combust if exposed to sufficient heat and oxygen. Now let us talk about chain reaction. The combustion process often involves a chain reaction, where the heat produced by the initial burning of fuel sustains and propagates the combustion through a continuous cycle of reactions. Understanding the chain reaction is crucial for comprehending the self-sustaining nature of fires. For example, expanding on the chain reaction in the context of a candle flame. When you light a candle, the heat from the flame melts the wax at the candle's base. The liquid wax is drawn up the wick through capillary action. As the wax reaches the flame's vicinity, it vaporizes and undergoes combustion, producing heat and light. The heat generated by this combustion process further melts more wax, repeating the cycle and sustaining the flame. The chain reaction continues as long as there is sufficient fuel, that is wax, and oxygen to support combustion. Now let us talk about flame formation. The visible flame in a fire is a result of incandescence from hot gases and particles produced during combustion. Flame formation is a complex process involving the interaction of different chemical species, temperature gradients, and the release of energy. For example, elaborating on flame formation in the context of burning a piece of wood. As wood undergoes pyrolysis and releases volatile gases, these gases mix with oxygen in the air. When ignited, the mixture undergoes combustion, producing a variety of hot gases, including water vapor and carbon dioxide. The incandescent particles in the flame result from the intense heat generated during combustion. These hot particles emit light in various colors, depending on the temperature and composition, contributing to the visible flame. The flame's shape is influenced by factors such as air currents and the geometry of the burning material. Now let us talk about three-sided fire triangle. The concept of fire triangle is a fundamental framework for understanding combustion. It consists of three essential elements that must be present for a fire to occur: heat, fuel, and oxygen. The interdependence of these elements forms the basis for controlling and preventing fires. For example, elaborating on the three-sided fire triangle in the context of a kitchen fire. Imagine a stovetop burner being turned on to cook food. The heat generated is the initial component of the fire triangle. Place a pan with cooking oil on the hot burner. द ऑयल सर्व्स एज द फ्यूल नेसेसरी फॉर कंबस्चन. द सराउंडिंग एयर प्रोवाइड्स द ऑक्सीजन रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द कंबस्चन ऑफ द कुकिंग ऑयल ऑन द हॉट स्टोव टॉप. एज दीज थ्री एलिमेंट्स कम टूगेदर, हीट फ्रॉम द बर्नर, कुकिंग ऑयल एज फ्यूल एंड ऑक्सीजन फ्रॉम द एयर, ए फायर इग्नाइट्स ऑन द स्टोव टॉप. रिमूविंग एनी वन ऑफ दीज एलिमेंट्स सच एज टर्निंग ऑफ द हीट सोर्स, कवरिंग द पैन टू कट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन और रिमूविंग द फ्यूल सोर्स कैन एक्सटिंग्विश द फायर. नाउ लेट अस टॉक अबाउट फायर टेट्राहेड्रॉन. बिल्डिंग अपन द फायर ट्राइंगल, द फायर टेट्राहेड्रॉन इंक्लूड्स ए फोर्थ एलिमेंट, द केमिकल रिएक्शन. दिस एम्फेसाइजेज दैट ए सेल्फ सस्टेनिंग केमिकल चेन रिएक्शन इज नेसेसरी फॉर ए फायर टू परसिस्ट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, एक्सपेंडिंग ऑन द फायर टेट्राहेड्रॉन इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ ए बर्निंग कैंडल, द फ्लेम फ्रॉम ए मैच प्रोवाइड्स द इनिशियल हीट सोर्स टू इग्नाइट द वीक ऑफ द कैंडल. द वैक्स इन द कैंडल सर्व्स एज द फ्यूल, मेल्टिंग एंड देन बीइंग ड्रॉन अप द वीक टू द फ्लेम. द सराउंडिंग एयर सप्लाइज द ऑक्सीजन रिक्वायर्ड फॉर कंबस्चन, अलोइंग द वैक्स वेपर टू बर्न. द कंबस्चन ऑफ द वैक्स इन्वॉल्व्स ए कॉम्प्लेक्स केमिकल रिएक्शन, breaking down the hydrocarbons in the wax into carbon dioxide and water vapor, releasing energy in the form of heat and light. The ongoing chemical reaction sustains the flame, creating a continuous cycle of wax melting, vaporization and combustion. Now let us talk about the flash point. And no, this is not the disease crisis event. The flash point is a critical parameter in fire safety, representing the minimal temperature at which a substance can ignite and sustain combustion when exposed to an ignition source. Understanding the flash point is essential for handling and storing flammable materials safely. For example, delving into the concept of flash point using gasoline. Gasoline, a common flammable liquid, has a relatively low flash point, typically around minus 40 degrees Celsius. If gasoline is exposed to an ignition source, such as a spark or open flame, at or above its flash point, it can vaporize and form an ignitable mixture with air. Below the flash point, the liquid gasoline may not release enough vapor to sustain combustion even in the presence of an ignition source. The flash point serves as a safety guideline informing users about the potential fire hazard associated with the substance. Now let us talk about spontaneous combustion. Spontaneous combustion occurs when a substance ignites without an external ignition source due to heat generated by its own chemical reactions. This phenomena is often associated with materials that can undergo self-heating, leading to ignition under certain conditions. For example, expanding on spontaneous combustion with a focus on oily rags. Linseed oil-soaked rags, commonly used in woodworking, can undergo spontaneous combustion. The oxidation of linseed oil is an exothermic reaction that generates heat over time. If a pile of linseed oil-soaked rags is left in a confined space, the heat generated during the oxidation process can accumulate. When the temperature reaches a critical point, the accumulated heat can cause the rags to self-ignite, leading to a fire without an external heat source. Proper disposal methods, such as storing these rags in a fire-resistant container or spreading them out to allow heat dissipation, help prevent spontaneous combustion incidents. Now let us talk about incomplete combustion. The incomplete combustion occurs when there is insufficient oxygen during the combustion process, leading to the production of byproducts such as carbon monoxide and soot. Understanding the conditions that result in incomplete combustion is vital for addressing safety concerns associated with the release of harmful substances. For example, exploring incomplete combustion with a focus on a gas stove. In a gas stove, natural gas, primarily methane, is a common fuel. When the stove is operating correctly, there is an adequate supply of oxygen for complete combustion, resulting in the production of carbon dioxide and water vapor. However, if the air supply is restricted, perhaps due to a malfunctioning burner or poor ventilation, incomplete combustion may occur. Incomplete combustion of methane produces carbon monoxide, a colorless and odorless gas that is highly toxic. The presence of carbon monoxide in the air can pose serious health risks, highlighting the importance of proper appliance, maintenance and ventilation. Now let us talk about wildfire spread. The spread of wildfires involves a combination of factors including wind, topography and fuel moisture. For example, examine wildfire spread in a forested area. The vegetation in a forest serves as fuel for wildfires. Dry leaves, branches and trees are susceptible to ignition. Wind is a significant factor influencing the rate and the direction of wildfire spread. Strong winds can carry embers over long distances, igniting new areas. The terrain plays a role in directing the path of a wildfire. Steep slopes can accelerate the spread, while valleys may slow it down. Dry conditions increase the flammability of vegetation. Low fuel moisture levels make it easier for a fire to ignite and spread. Activities such as campfires, discarded cigarettes, or equipment sparking can introduce ignition sources, contributing to wildfire initiation. Now let us talk about backdraft. Backdraft is a phenomenon that occurs when oxygen is rapidly reintroduced to a fire that has depleted its available oxygen, often due to incomplete combustion or ventilation issues. The sudden influx of oxygen can cause an explosive release of built-up gases, leading to a dangerous and rapid fire development. For example, exploring backdraft in the context of a building fire. A room in a building is on fire and the fire consumes the available oxygen, shifting the combustion toward incomplete combustion. Firefighters arrive and break a window or open a door to ventilate the room, introducing fresh oxygen. The sudden rush of oxygen rekindles the fire, causing a rapid and explosive release of accumulated gases. These gases, including carbon monoxide and flammable vapors, combust more completely in the presence of the newly introduced oxygen, leading to a sudden and intense fire expansion. The potential dangers of backdraft emphasize the importance of coordinated firefighting strategies, including proper ventilation techniques, to avoid sudden and hazardous changes in fire behavior. Now let us talk about fire extinguishment. Fire extinguishment involves the interruption of one or more elements of the fire triangle or fire tetrahedron to suppress and ultimately extinguish a fire. Various methods and extinguishing agents are used based on the type of fire and materials involved. For example, detailing fire extinguishment using a water-based method. Water is a common extinguishing agent, particularly for fires involving ordinary combustibles that are Class A fires. When water is applied to a fire, it cools the burning material, reducing its temperature below the ignition point and disrupting the heat element of the fire triangle. Additionally, water can create a barrier between fuel and oxygen, preventing the reignition of combustible materials. In the case of flammable liquid fires that are Class B fires, the foam or dry chemical agents might be used to suppress vapors and create a barrier between the fuel and oxygen. Understanding the specific properties of different extinguishing agents and their compatibility with the type of fire is crucial for effective fire suppression. Now let us talk about fire classes. द फायर्स कैन बी कैटेगराइज्ड इनटू डिफरेंट क्लासेस बेस्ड ऑन द टाइप ऑफ फ्यूल इन्वॉल्व्ड. क्लास ए इन्वॉल्व्स ऑर्डिनरी कंबस्टिबल्स सच एज वुड, पेपर एंड फैब्रिक. वाटर इज ए टाइपिकल एक्सटिंग्विशिंग एजेंट फॉर क्लास ए फायर्स एज इट कूल्स द मटेरियल एंड डिप्राइव्स इट ऑफ हीट. क्लास बी encompasses flammable liquids and gases. Extinguishing agents might include foam, dry chemical powders or carbon dioxide depending on the specific characteristics of the fuel. Class C involves electrical fires. Extinguishing agents must be non-conductive to avoid electric shock. Carbon dioxide or dry chemical agents are often used for class C fires. Class D encompasses fires involving combustible metals. Specialized extinguishing agents such as dry powder or sand are needed for these unique fire hazards. Class K primarily associated with kitchen fires involving cooking oils and fats. Wet chemical extinguishers are suitable for suppressing these fires. As they react with the cooking oils, to form a soapy layer that seals the surface. For example, illustrating fire classes with a scenario, imagine a restaurant kitchen where a fire breaks out in a deep fryer containing cooking oil like class K fire. Traditional water-based extinguishers could be ineffective and even dangerous in this scenario, as water would not extinguish the oil fire. Instead, the water might cause splattering. Using a wet chemical extinguisher designed for class K fires, the cook can apply the agent to the burning oil, forming a layer that prevents reignition. Understanding the specific fire class is crucial in choosing the right extinguishing method, preventing the use of ineffective or potentially harmful agents. Now let us talk about heat of combustion. The heat of combustion refers to the amount of heat released per unit mass of a substance during complete combustion. This measure helps understand the energy potential of different fuels and is valuable in various fields, including energy production and fire safety. For example, exploring the heat of combustion with a focus on gasoline. Gasoline is a common automotive fuel with a relatively high heat of combustion. The combustion reaction for gasoline involves combining it with oxygen to form carbon dioxide and water vapor, releasing a significant amount of heat. The high heat of combustion of gasoline is why it is efficient fuel for internal combustion engines, providing substantial energy for vehicle propulsion. So, this was a brief info on fire. I will talk more about fire in a later video. In summary, in the intricate world of combustion, a series of interconnected processes and factors come into play, shaping the dynamics of fires and influencing fire safety measures. At the heart of this complex phenomena is the ignition process, where a source, such as a matchstick, initiates the chemical reactions that define combustion. The fuel, often composed of organic materials, like wood or paper, undergo pyrolysis, breaking down into volatile gases and char when exposed to heat. The presence of oxygen is paramount, as it engages in a chemical reaction with the fuel, leading to an exothermic reaction that releases energy in the form of heat and light. This exothermic nature sustains the combustion process, creating a self-sustaining chain reaction that propels the fire forward. Heat transfer mechanisms come into play, as the heat generated during combustion is transferred to adjacent fuel, facilitating its breakdown and participation in the combustion process. The resulting flame is a visual manifestation of incandescence from hot gases and particles produced during combustion. Understanding the fire triangle, which consists of heat, fuel, and oxygen, become pivotal as these three elements must coexist for a fire to thrive. Expanding upon this, The fire tetrahedron introduces a fourth element, the chemical reaction, emphasizing that a sustained chemical process is crucial for the continuation of combustion. Flammable vapors add another layer to the complexity, especially in scenarios involving liquids or volatile compounds. For instance, the evaporation of gasoline and the subsequent formation of an ignitable mixture with air exemplify how flammable vapors contribute to the overall combustibility. Pyrolysis, often occurring in solid fuels like wood, precedes combustion and plays a pivotal role in releasing flammable gases that fuel the fire. In the dance of these elements, the flame formation becomes a mesmerizing display of the chemical reactions and incandescence involved in combustion. Transitioning from flame to fire safety, the concept of three-sided fire triangle becomes a guiding principle. Heat, fuel, and oxygen must be present simultaneously for combustion to occur, and disrupting any of these elements can extinguish a fire. This evolves into the fire tetrahedron, where the chemical reaction takes center stage. It is not merely about the presence of three elements, it is about their interaction in a sustained chemical process. Delving into specifics, the flash point of a substance becomes a critical parameter, defining the minimum temperature at which it can ignite and sustain combustion. Using the example of gasoline with its low flash point, we see how this knowledge is essential for handling and storing flammable materials safely. On the flip side, spontaneous combustion adds a layer of unpredictability, showcasing how certain materials, such as linseed oil-soaked rags, can ignite without external sources due to self-heating. Incomplete combustion introduces a cautionary note, as the insufficiency of oxygen can lead to the production of harmful byproducts like carbon monoxide. A gas stove scenario illustrates the potential risks associated with incomplete combustion, emphasizing the importance of proper ventilation in preventing the release of toxic substances. Simultaneously, the spread of wildfires, influenced by factors like wind, topography, and fuel moisture, underscores the need for comprehensive strategies in managing and predicting these destructive events. Venturing further into the realm of fire safety, backdraft emerges as a potential hazard when oxygen is rapidly reintroduced to a fire that has depleted its available oxygen. Using the example of a building fire, the scenario highlights the explosive release of built-up gases and underscores the importance of cautious ventilation practices in firefighting. On the other hand, fire extinguishment strategies become a beacon of hope in emergencies. Water, a common extinguishing agent, cools the burning material and creates a barrier between the fuel and oxygen, disrupting the elements of the fire triangle. Navigating through the diverse classes of fires, each categorized based on the type of fuel involved, we discern the importance of tailored firefighting approaches. From ordinary combustibles of class A to flammable liquids and gases of class B and electrical fires of class C, each class demands a specific set of extinguishing agents and techniques. The example of a kitchen fire involving cooking oils of class K showcases how wet chemical extinguishers react with the oils to form a soapy layer, preventing reignition. Concluding with a deeper dive into the energy potential of fuels, the concept of heat of combustion takes center stage. Using the example of gasoline, with its high heat of combustion, we recognize the efficiency of this fuel in powering internal combustion engines. This knowledge becomes a valuable tool not only in energy production but also in evaluating the potential severity of fires involving different fuels. The journey through ignition, fuel breakdown, chemical reactions, and safety measures unveil the multidimensional nature of this fundamental process that has both captivated and challenged humanity throughout history.
Thank you very much for watching. And may we solve faster neuron firing and wiring heating issues associated with mind emulation and experience years of time in mere days.